Congratulations being here in Dallas, and I mean, how does that feel for you right now? You're local, right?
I live here. It's amazing. It feels like a little hometown, not a little, but it feels like a nice hometown screening. Johnny, one of our lead actors, grew up here, and Greg Guidard, the director, is from DFW, and so it's amazing to be here. It's really cool.
So, I heard that you guys did a lot of research. You just didn't go on the internet and say, Border Patrol, let's see what's up with that. You actually went and did it.
Yeah, we spent a lot of time out there. We had written our first draft, Greg and I had, and we got through it and we realized there's so much that we don't know. And there's just things that you can't know about a subject from just reading about it in books or reading about articles about it. And so we felt like we had to get out there, meet Border Patrol agents, get out in the desert and experience it and see it for ourselves. So it was amazing. And there's so much in the movie that that is based on facts. I think most of the experiences are based on stories we heard, and hopefully the characters ring true to Border Patrol agents out there.
How did they allow you? How did they, feel comfortable enough with you to tell their stories?
Yeah, it's interesting. The Border Patrol itself, the agency never helped us out or condoned the movie. They never had any participation in it. When we were talking to agents by themselves, when they were off duty and just hanging out, drinking beers with them and hanging out, talking to them, once they saw that we had a genuine interest in what they were doing and we weren't trying to pull something on them, we weren't trying to catch them at something, it was just, we're interested in you, we feel like this is an important story to tell, what you go through day in and day out, then they opened up completely. So it's like any person, once they feel like they know that they have a story to tell, once they realize that you want to tell the story in a genuine and honest way, they'll go on with it.
Well, I'm sure then you had a lot of stories, probably more than you could put in the movie, so how did you pick what you were going to tell?
Part of it is just what's going to be believable, because we heard so much that it seems like a sci-fi movie if
we
put it in there. Yeah, so much we had to dial back, we couldn't put in there because it seems outrageous.
Yeah.
But then the other thing was our film is set in 24 hours with three agents in the desert. And so just by the fact of that, there's certain things you can't put in, like what they go through, the amount of paperwork they have to do at the office and things like that, which is insane. Yes, but it's also like a big part of the job that you know, if they pick up someone, just the bureaucracy is as mind-numbing as anything else, and the bureaucracy that the agents have to endure is a big thing that cartels use to turn agents to their side.
Oh my goodness.
Because the bureaucracy is so steeped, and there's people in Washington making decisions that affect these men and women's lives, and the people in Washington most times have never even been to the border. So.
And that
not to get political. We wanted to make an apolitical movie. The movie's not political.
So tell me about the characters then.
The characters are very interesting. We've got three agents who all have very different views of their job. One has a view of a very black and white view of the world, that there needs to, you know, there's a line, you need to protect it. The other is a little more humanist about it and sees the gray area in it. And then the third one doesn't really care. It's a job, and he doesn't really think too much about whether you should, you know, bar people or not. The thing is that we did is we let all of those characters, by the end of the movie, their views are a little different. So you go in thinking like, oh, I know what this actor thinks, I know what this character thinks, and then by the end it's a little, it shades a different direction. So
that just makes you a good screenwriter then.
We had a lot of good stuff to work with, and the actors, honestly, the script went, it got 10 times better when the actors came on, because they all threw themselves into the material. They worked with Border Patrol agents as well, and brought things to the script that we had no idea existed. So
how much of the other side do you put in as far as like people crossing the border? I mean, I'm sure you have actors that are...
Yeah, it's in there as well, for sure. And some of our... that's in there as well. But we always... We never wanted to... None of it is... none of it was put in there to make a statement of any kind. It was just that there's a line that we drew on the map and said, this is this country and that's that country. And there's people on one side trying to get across, there's people on one side trying to stop those people, but they're those people. They're all just people. And so that's in there. I don't know, we just try to steep everything in the truth of the area as much as possible.
What was the thing that surprised you the most that maybe people don't know about? Or
you know, I think just everything about the job of a Border Patrol agent surprised us. Neither of us went in, neither Greg or I went in wanting to make a film about Border Patrol. We love the world of the border, and it's fascinating and needs to be examined with the amount we talk about it in the press. But we never thought it would be set in Border Patrol. And then once we started learning about those people and learning about their job, it just opened up a whole new world that we didn't know was there.
So last questions. Were there any alien stories?
People coming across, or like?
No, I'm talking about like little green men, you know, because they're out there all alone.
Yeah, there are. Well, in Marfa, where the film is set in the West Texas region, and when we were doing our research, we were out in Marfa, and there's the famous mystery lights out there, which are these lights that pop up on the horizon, and they act in ways that don't really make any sense scientifically, and there's a lot of theories about what they are, but we definitely saw the mystery lights a few times, so we'll leave it at that, not to get too esoteric. Yeah, the mystery lights, yeah.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you
so much.
Yeah, have a good day.